In this video, we're computing the indefinite integral of 2x+5 to the 7th power. So first we're going to do this informally by using the chain rule backwards. We're just guessing the antiderivative, but taking the chain rule into consideration as we do that. Then second, we'll use an explicit u-substitution to find the same answer. So in the informal approach to this integral, I just view this as a function composition. 2x+5 all raised to the 7th power is a composition where the inner function is 2x+5. Now remember, what the chain rule does is it tacks on the derivative of the interior function when you differentiate a thing. So if we can get the derivative of that interior function, and that's a 2, sitting right next to that function raised to the 7th power, it's going to make it a lot easier to see the chain rule backwards. Of course, you can't just go around multiplying things by 2 whenever you want. You have to compensate out in front with a factor of 1/2. So now that I've taken care of the consequences of the chain rule here, that's the derivative of the interior function, it makes it very simple to guess the antiderivative. This 1/2 out in front is a spectator, and then the antiderivative of my integrand here is just going to be a 1/8 times the interior function, 2x+5 to the 8th power. That's just applying the power rule. And we can clean things up to 1/16 times the quantity 2x+5 to the 8th plus c. Now, as you're working to become more comfortable with using the chain rule backwards in an informal way, it's wise to just constantly check these antiderivatives by using the derivative. As you do that, you're going to use the chain rule, and using the chain rule forwards makes you better at using it backwards. So if we just focus on this piece of it real quick, the 1/8 2x+5 to the 8th power, and look at the derivative of that just to verify we've done everything correctly, you're going to differentiate with respect to the interior function first. So we end up with a 1/8 times 8, 2x+5 to the 7th power. But then the chain rule tells us we have to tack on the derivative of the interior function, and that was 2. The 8s are going to cancel, and I end up with that 2 times the quantity 2x+5 to the 7th that I built into the integrand of this thing. Okay, with practice, that informal chain rule backwards approach can become much more efficient than making an explicit u-substitution every single time. But I do want to follow up by showing how the u-substitution works on this integral. Basically, to get a sense of direction on the u-substitution approach, you need to recognize this as a function composition from the beginning anyway. And what you're going to do is give the name u to the inner function here. So we say let u equal 2x+5. And then we transform the differential as well. So du is going to be the derivative of this expression times dx. That's going to be a 2dx. And then I have a couple ways I could go. I could modify my integrand the same way I did in my first approach and just throw a 2 into the integrand and a 1/2 out in front. And there's a 2dx. And then I can turn it into a du. It's also popular to just solve for the dx here. So I'm just going to do it that way this time, just for the sake of variety. And I can say that dx is 1/2 du. So then we transform our integral in terms of u. And now 2x+5 to the 7th is actually u to the 7th. And then dx is a 1/2 du. We can clean things up a little by moving the 1/2 out in front. And I have 1/2 u to the 7th du. And so there's our simple power function again. And that's going to integrate to 1/8 u to the 8th plus c. And then I replace the u with its definition in terms of x, and I end up with 1/16 times the quantity 2x+5 to the 8th plus c, and we get to the same answer. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.